My name is Sierra, and our company is Sweetheart Bake Shop. We've been in business for about 6.5 years, and it has been a crazy journey just going from something that was a hobby that I was just doing for fun to something that we're doing weddings every weekend, usually between 3 to 6 weddings every weekend. Probably about 80% of what we do is weddings, but we do stuff for other occasions as well. We do mostly wedding cakes and wedding dessert bars. So we do a lot of the big buffet tables where, you know, you see a cake in the middle of the table and then you'll have a whole bunch of big spread of a bunch of desserts. That's what we've been doing a lot more of recently, but I always love a real big decorative cake as well. I started decorating cakes just for fun a long time ago, just making them for my family. Not at all decorating them, just baking them and making them a big mess that tasted good. And it would just be a big pile of stuff with candy and caramel and all kinds of things on top. And wasn't that all something I tried to make pretty, but once I started getting into the wedding industry, I worked as a wedding planner, as a bridal gown salesperson, and just an invitation designer, and quite a few other things. I also assisted my husband, who's doing wedding photography. I was very actively involved in the wedding industry, so I was seeing wedding cakes on a regular basis, and I realized that it looked like something that looked like fun, so I started playing and doing some research. I never went to cake decorating school or pastry school or anything like that. It was all online research and trial and error, a lot of recipes, playing with a lot of recipes. And I started posting pictures online of stuff that I was making, and very shortly people started contacting me to place an order. And that's not at all why I posted pictures. I was just like, hey, look what I've been doing, this has been fun. And people started placing orders, and then they started referring their friends and family to place orders. And I realized that I suddenly had started a business, which was totally unintentional, but it has been one of the best things that's happened to me, because I feel like I finally figured out what I want to be when I grow up. My favorite part of the wedding, see, I'm not there for the whole thing, so I don't get to be a part of the entire wedding day, but what I do love is sometimes I'll stick around to see the bride and groom's reactions when they see their wedding cake. And no matter how much time went into the cake, no matter how tired I may be from being up for hours and hours decorating their cake, however much went into that cake, it is just such a reminder of how excited I am about what I do and how, you know, the work that we do matters. And that moment of just seeing, you know, their smiles and seeing how happy they are and seeing them be like, oh my gosh, that's the cake that we sketched out, or that's the cake that we, you know, that we envisioned, and there's the real thing coming to life. I mean, that's just, it's such a special thing for me to see that. And then when I get photos after the wedding and see their cake cutting and stuff, you just see the couple surrounded by their family and friends, and I just think that's a really special moment. My most memorable client experiences are not actually so much on the wedding days, because typically I'm dropping off the cake or the desserts and then I'm leaving, but it happens for me more of in the planning process. During the wedding cake consultations, they'll come in and they'll meet with me, and typically it's supposed to be a 1-hour meeting, but I can be talkative and they can be talkative. And there are some times where I'm in a meeting with someone for, you know, a couple hours, and by the end of it, we're like best friends by the end of it. And there's actually been a few of our couples that, you know, years later, 4 or 5 years later, we are good friends with, we hang out on a regular basis. And I just think it's so fun that I never really know who's going to be walking in the door for that wedding cake consultation, that it's something that sometimes I make a really good connection with those people, and that's important to me. I want to make a connection that goes beyond just the wedding day. A lot of times these people keep me in mind for years later, for baby showers and birthdays and all that kind of stuff, so I think it's important to have a good, healthy client relationship. So we've been doing wedding cakes here for weddings and other occasions, but for about 5 years now, and they've been, you know, so sweet to put us on the recommended vendor list, and we've been so thankful to be getting quite a few referrals from them. But we are here probably at least a couple times a month, and I have just had such a wonderful experience with the people who work there, with the people who help run the place, everyone from the people who are in charge to the individual servers and people who are helping everyone on a day-to-day basis. I feel like they just really care, and when I go to set up, it's not just, oh, put it over there. You know, they actually come and they're like, okay, how can we help you? Make sure everything looks good. Make sure everything is perfect. And I feel like there's a difference between, you know, people who are just there to do their job and people who actually love what they do. And I really feel that about the employees at Las Robles Greens, is that they actually, you know, really genuinely care and put a lot of love into it. As far as the delivery of the wedding cakes, I like to deliver about 1 hour before the guests enter the reception space. With an indoor venue, we can do about 2 hours before, but with an outdoor venue, about 1 hour before is usually what's best. And that's one thing that's great about this venue, is that they have both the indoor and the outdoor space, that you have both options. But I love that it's so convenient when I come here. The parking is easy, everything. I've been here so many times, I know right where to go. The staff is really sweet about guiding me exactly to where, you know, it's going to be set up. And, you know, there's a few things to consider with an outdoor wedding. You want to consider the placement of the cake, where the best place is going to be. They have a few different spots here that it always looks beautiful, whether we use that big, beautiful buffet station there. We've had tables set up in different areas. But there's so many beautiful backdrops here that no matter where we put the cake, it always ends up looking so beautiful for your photos. You know, you don't have to decide, do I want a big cake? Do I want a little cake, a dessert bar? You don't have to make that decision and decide one or the other. You can still have the best of both worlds. You know, if you want to have a two-tier cake, a three-tier cake, something that's not necessarily a huge five-tier cake or six-tier cake, but having something that's, you know, maybe a two or three tier in the middle, and then having a really beautiful dessert spread around it. We can decorate the cake more simple, or we can still go more detailed with it, and then your guests will have choices of what they want to eat. Some people are more of a cake person. I'm a cake person. I love cake, but there are the few people in the universe who exist that are not cake people. I don't understand those people, but there are a few people like that. And those are the people who are going to so appreciate that you've got some other options besides cake. So when it comes to designing the cake, it's an incredibly fun process for me. You know, some of it has to do with my ideas, but the majority of it comes from the couple's ideas. You know, a lot of times I'll ask them when they're ready to come in for their wedding cake consultation to bring me a few pieces of inspiration. And it doesn't just mean cakes, because a lot of times people just come with photos of other cakes they've seen. And that's helpful because it helps me know what they like and what they don't like. But what's helpful really for me is to see what are the other elements of your wedding. Show me what your flowers are gonna look like. Show me what your invitations are gonna look like. Some of the other inspirations from like the fabrics. When the bride shows me her wedding dress, sometimes we'll do stuff that's inspired by, you know, the lace on the gown or different things like that. But there's so many different areas that we pull ideas from. So yes, I do like having cake inspiration pictures, but that's just a small part of it. A big part of it is just how can we make your cake connect with all the other details of your wedding and represent you. And sometimes people want to go something elegant and beautiful, and sometimes people want to go for something where this cake literally represents us to a T. I had a cake one time that this couple wanted their scuba divers, and they wanted literally them on a cake as scuba divers in their bride and groom tux and wedding dress, surrounded by fish and sea turtles and all these different things, and the boat that she grew up on, and the shoes, like literally down to their exact pairs of shoes that they wear, sitting on the edge of the boat. I mean, all these little tiny details. And so sometimes people want me to really have fun and make the cake super personalized to them. Other times people are just wanting something really elegant and really classic that is gonna be just as in style now as it will be when they're showing their grandkids one day. And I think that it's just interesting to see different couples with their different styles, and anything we can do to specialize it and customize it for them.